guys, welcome back to a brand new video. Tonight we are going to be unboxing Pinocchio from Disney's second animated film, Pinocchio. So cool. You guys, I love Pinocchio. It is one of my favorite Disney films of all time, along with Snow White. The first two Disney films are so, even Fantasia, I would say. Like, it's not in my top 10, but I love it. The first three animated films are just absolutely special in their own ways. I love the darkness and the light of all of them. I think that's what makes them stand out to me personally. Each one of the first three films has so much darkness in them, but also has a lot of light in them too with these characters. Pinocchio representing the light, Jiminy Cricket, Geppetto, the Blue Fairy, Figaro, Cleo, super beautiful characters that we love. Snow White, same thing, Snow White, the Seven Dwarves, the Prince. And then with Fantasia, obviously Mickey in certain segments have like balanced light and dark very well. So I love that these original three films have that, and these characters are just completely iconic and stand the test of time. Can you believe that Pinocchio was done in 1940 along with Fantasia? Snow White was 1937, but can you believe that it's been that long? We're coming up on 100 years, you guys, of these films. 100 years in what, like the next 20 years, right? Like in 20, like less than 20 years from now, I think 19 years from now, this movie will be 100 years old. Pinocchio, you don't look a day over five. Love it. All right, let's take a look at the back of the box. On the back of this box, we have Figaro with Cleo, who I will get eventually. We have Jiminy Cricket, who I will also get eventually as well. The Blue Fairy, who we've unboxed together now. Geppetto, who I've unboxed with you guys as well. And Pinocchio, who I will be unboxing in this video. Guys, I also have previous Pinocchio videos as well, when I unboxed Pinocchio Pop in a Box exclusive and Jiminy Cricket, who was a con exclusive. So there are a few other Pinocchio Pop unboxings if you guys are fans of Pinocchio. Let's get right into this. He was about $12.50 at GameStop along with his father Geppetto, and I believe Blue Fairy was about $10 on Amazon. I think that was the price for these things. Let's get into this. Here we go. Pinocchio. All right, here he is out of his box, looking absolutely cute. I love Pinocchio. Again, one of my favorite characters growing up. It was him, Peter Pan. Those are my two, like Mowgli. Those are like my kid favorites because I was a kid too. I think even Taran from Black Cauldron was the, like, if you were a kid, like an animated kid in a Disney film, I automatically loved you because I was just like, I'm a kid, they're a kid, cool. So I loved that. But Pinocchio and Peter have been like my favorite too since I was a child. So I love them. Anytime Pinocchio has a brand new pop, I want to get it for sure. And I'm actually really happy about the fact that Pinocchio has about three pops now. Like, I love the original one, which I do have as well. I love this one, and then the one that came out from Pop in a Box about a year or two ago. Super duper cute. And I love that they're all three so different. Like, I look at this one is in a different pose with an apple and a book in his hand. The other one that I got from Pop in a Box has like Jiminy Cricket on the end of his nose, and he looks kind of worried, or Jiminy looks like he's kind of scolding him, and then the original pop. So I love that there's three different ones. I would have absolutely loved to enjoy unboxing this pop in Disneyland right about now, but unfortunately that isn't what's happening. But I might take him on a future, I might take many of them on future Disney trips when and if the parks reopen anytime soon. He is up close. He does have a little bit of a little nose issue there, but that's not a big deal at all. I love his hair. So cute. Look at that bow tie right there. Oh, adorable. The colors in this pop, like the green book, great choice. Yeah, like just look at the details on like the pants and like the leggings and, or the pants, the like shorts and stuff. Very, very cute. Look at the details. It's the details, you guys, and they're doing such a great job, Funko, with these details on these characters and just all the things that they're putting in. The work that they're putting in just makes them feel all the more special and authentic, and just, you know, like the character. I think that's the most important part. I do really want a human Pinocchio in the future, but we'll get into that in a little bit. Here he is doing his famous spin. I love this. Again, just like his father, he's in an action pose. That's cool. It shows that he's going to school. There's, you know, like, I like when they're in action poses because it kind of looks like there's like a story going on there. They're not just standing there, you know what I mean? I love that. And there is a Pinocchio. There is the original version of him that is just standing there. So if you wanted that version, you can obviously get that version, but it's cool that they have an option of this version too. I love that. Super, super cute. I actually love that this song is playing. This is I Got a Dream from Tangled, because he's actually in this scene in the movie. I mean, look at God. Look at God just working, you guys. That's perfect. This is actually perfect right now. I love that. Yeah, super duper cute. I love Pinocchio. One of my favorite characters for sure. I would love different versions of Pinocchio as well. Like, I would love to have a donkey version of Pinocchio, because that's in the movie. I'd love to have like a version of him with like the strings attached. Would be kind of cute. I would love a human version of Pinocchio too. As much as I know people will be like, what is the point of having a human version of Pinocchio when the whole purpose of Pinocchio is that he's not human, he's a puppet. I don't know, like, to me, an end of movie version of Pinocchio as a real boy would be super, super cute. I would even love like a Pinocchio sequel. There have been a few different companies that have like flirted with the idea of having Pinocchio sequels, like that are not Disney, obviously. And I like each and every one of their versions of the tale, like the retellings. I love that. I think The New Adventures of Pinocchio with Jonathan Taylor Thomas and its sequel, even though there are two different actors playing Pinocchio in those movies, and one, like the second one is obviously a much smaller, low budget film. It's still, I love the second film, actually. I've watched that more than the first one. I love both of them for sure, but I like that version of the second movie has a kind of cool little twist in it. I love it. And there's more of the character of Lampwick, which I love because Lampwick is one of my favorite characters. So even though it's a very cheap sequel to the other Jonathan Taylor Thomas version, it's absolutely worth the watch. Okay, guys, and here he is back to center looking amazing. Once again, this is my boy, Pinocchio. Him and Peter Pan, you guys. Anytime I get Peter Pan, Pinocchio pops, I am excited. I am ready. You guys, that Peter Pan pop that came out last year for the 65th anniversary, like him in the ship, I was so stoked for that pop for so long. And then the one with him versus Hook, like they're two separate pops. So I was so excited for that. And then when they announced new Pinocchio, like a few months later, I was like, you guys, you gotta stop. Because, you know, like Hercules, Aladdin, Pinocchio, Peter Pan, like Baymax, those are my boys. Robin Hood, Simba, like, those are my dudes. So anytime I get like new pops from them, I'm so, so excited. I don't know why, but I just like freak out. I would also love Meet the Robinsons pops. Treasure Planet pops, you guys, like Jim Hawkins. Yeah, I want a Jim Hawkins pop. I would love a John Silver pop. A Morph pop, you guys. Like, but here's the thing. If we do get a Treasure Planet pop series, this is what I want. Please Funko, if you're listening, which I think you are, I think so, I would love to have Jim Hawkins, like obviously regular Jim Hawkins, and then Jim Hawkins in his like military uniform at the end of the film. You guys, please make that happen. Please Funko, make that happen. That would be legit. Also do a pop rides of Jim Hawkins on like the like sky thing that he's on. Please make that happen, you guys. Oh my god, Funko, like seriously, please make that happen. Like, no but like, please, like, I would love those three pops of Jim Hawkins. Would they sell, Funko? Yes, they would sell. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for all of your likes, your follows, subscribes, and for sharing. If you are not subscribed to the channel yet, what are you doing? Make sure to subscribe, ring that bell for notifications, and leave me a nice big like on this video. It's been, you guys, like all the work that I am doing. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day. Actually, have a magical day, night, evening, afternoon, wherever, whenever you're watching this, make sure it's magical. Have a great day.